Frank, my colleague, my Spartan warrior in academia, my fellow Hans Ulrich Rudel, dive bombing our intellectual stukas into the brains of second graders. You can't seem to conjugate your verb.
Conjugate.
The drink you drank, which then of course would make you drunk, or drunk-er.
Oh, that. I've heard you're a wordsmith, Mr.
Harry. It's Harry. And that, over there, is Gladys.
My husband's not a wordsmith, Frank. He's more like a Smith and Wesson, or perhaps a Hotchkiss gun, which was known to jam on the veldt, much to the delight of the boar.
Oh, the delight of the boar.
Is that the best you've got? I shouldn't be surprised that the word boar would come out of your lips, considering that you are such a boar, and that you look like a boar with your tusks and tail.
I assume you're explaining your jokes to the peanut gallery?
I love peanuts.
All we have are cashews.
I meant the comic strip.
Someday Charlie Brown will kick that football.
And one glorious day, I will kick your face in.
Ding dong ditty.
I have hated you from the moment that I saw you. You reminded me of nothing more than a leech at the bottom of a bog. You attached yourself to my leg with your disgusting, multitude, sucking mouth, dripping with anesthetic so I wouldn't feel as you sucked the life's blood out of my body and my soul like a filth-covered succubus riding in on the back of a demon in the night. Of course, I limped before a priest with her witch-like visage at my side, and I looked the priest in the eye and I said, I will.
Oh.
I will take this woman. I will take this woman, and I will smash her head against the nearest brownstone until I feel the ecstasy of her brain matter spilling out of her ears and her nasal cavities. Oh, God, how I wish. Oh, God, how I wish I could.
I understand you two are to be married. So when's the happy day?
Next June, in New Hampshire, next to the world's tallest polished granite shaft.
Well, be sure to mark your calendars. That'll be the last day you ever have sex.
Oh, no, it will be the first.
We're Mormons.
We aren't allowed to lie with one another until we've been married.
Make the sacrifice when you live for God.
God? What? Your Mormon God? The one discovered by Joseph Smith looking at broken rocks in the bottom of a hat, which caused him to be expelled from his idyllic New York hamlet as a charlatan, having him traipsing across the country until he meets his demise in Illinois? The rest of you knee-crawling your way to Utah with your multiple wives? Multiple wives? Oh, God, what a horror show. I can see it now. One Gladys, barefoot and pregnant in the kitchen. Another Gladys, upstairs making the bed. Another still, stinking up my bathroom. And another Gladys, taking my car to the grocery store, buying things that we don't need. And a final Uber Gladys, watching her stories on that blasted television while I marvel at the size of her ass.
Please excuse my husband. He's a fucktard.
Bitch.
Masturbator.
Harlot.
Cock gobbler.
Twat? Twat? I can't hear you. I have an ear infection.
We don't practice polygamy anymore.
Oh, I love you, you flatulent cow.
And I you, you limp-noodled ponce.
You remember when Boni Moroni danced the frug before the Parthenon?
Well, who can remember that?
True. But Aeschylus made me believe that I was there.
We can talk about the parent-teacher meetings another time.
The dip was really great. I never knew you could combine artichoke and mayonnaise and it could be so good together.
What? Wait! No! We haven't had the champagne!
Champagne, Gladys?
Champagne for the celebration.
Celebration, Gladys?
I have an announcement.
Announcement, Gladys?
I'm with child.
But that's impossible.
I haven't slogged through your mossy cleft in over a year.
And I thank you for that. But others have. Right, Frank?
Oh, mossy cleft. Sounds very beautiful.
Well played, Gladys.